chances are you suffer from chronic dehydration. After all, statistics show that over 75% of Americans do. That's close to 328.2 million people. While dehydration is common, it doesn't look the same in everyone. Its signs and symptoms can vary depending on the person affected, as well as the severity of the condition. Infants and children, as well as the elderly, are at increased risk for dehydration. Plus, what doctors classify as a mild to moderate case of dehydration varies from severe dehydration. Catching it early is key to proper dehydration treatment and prevention of a more serious case that could become life-threatening. So what is dehydration? Dehydration occurs when an individual loses more fluid than they take in. Since the body is made up of two-thirds water, it's essential for human life. In fact, water plays a large role in normal body functions, like facilitating digestion, lubricating the joints and eliminating toxins to keep the skin healthy. Even if your body has only lost 1-2% of its water content, it can have adverse effects that present themselves in the form of dehydration symptoms. A fluid deficit from water loss can leave you feeling thirsty or sleepy, as well as having a mild headache, dry mouth with bad breath or muscle cramps, often referred to as Charlie horses. You likely won't have the urge to use the bathroom as frequently, as you'll experience minimal urine output. As fluid loss worsens from one being mildly to moderately to severely dehydrated, it can lead to signs of mental and physical decline that will need immediate action for reversal. If symptoms of severe dehydration are concerning enough, they may also require the assistance of a medical professional. 1. Not urinating or very dark urine. An easy way to test and see if you're dehydrated is checking the color of your urine. Normal urine should be pale yellow in color, like lemonade. If your urine is a darker color, similar to apple juice, this could be a sign of moderate to severe dehydration. Not urinating at all. You're most likely severely dehydrated. What to do? Should you find your urine as a dark yellow, be sure to start drinking more water immediately. It's best to take small sips of water your body can properly absorb, rather than gulping down glass after glass of water that your kidneys will expel. If you feel you're not getting enough fluids on a regular basis, consider taking a large water bottle with you to drink throughout the day, at work, in the car and on the go. 2. Dry skin that doesn't bounce back when pinched. Checking the color of your urine is not the only quick test you can perform to determine if you're dehydrated. A person's skin elasticity is also telling. Try this: pinch the skin on the top of your hand and see what happens. If it moves back slowly, this is an indication that you're mildly to moderately dehydrated. If the skin seems to stick together, this is a sign of severe dehydration. What to do? Like with darker urine, you should increase your water intake and drink fluids if you're experiencing mild to moderate dehydration. While a glass of water is a good go-to, if you've just finished a strenuous workout, you can also try rehydrating drinks like a sports drink or coconut water. If you are severely dehydrated and your skin tense, you may have to visit a healthcare provider who can help treat dehydration. 3. Rapid heartbeat and breathing. It's natural to have an increased heart rate and rapid breathing while exercising. But if your symptoms don't go away once you've cooled down, or you haven't been working out and you experience these symptoms, it could be a sign of severe dehydration as depleted amounts of electrolytes can affect the heart's ability to pump blood. What to do? Fluid intake is crucial for organs like your heart, liver, kidneys, and lungs to function properly. So, it's important you visit a doctor for dehydration when you experience these symptoms. After thorough examination, if a medical professional determines you are dehydrated, you'll likely be hooked up to receive intravenous fluid containing a concentrate rehydration solution, water with salts and sugars like sodium chloride and potassium, for quick delivery of fluids to the thirstiest parts of your body. 4. Confusion, dizziness or lightheadedness. Did you know that your brain is composed of 73% water? That's why drinking water and eating water-filled foods can help your brain work better. On the flip side, if you don't get enough fluids, it can have adverse effects. If you're feeling like you might pass out at any moment, or you're confused over where you are, how you got there or what you're doing, it might mean you are severely dehydrated. What to do? Don't take symptoms like these lightly. Properly rehydrate by slowing drinking water and eating water-filled foods like cucumbers, watermelon, tomatoes, strawberries, apples, and grapes. Both options will help replenish your body with the minerals and electrolytes it needs to absorb into the brain and tissues. If you're experiencing severe dehydration with confusion, you should go to the emergency room to be checked out by a healthcare provider. Tips for staying hydrated. The best way to avoid excessive fluid loss is to prevent dehydration in the first place. By following a few quick tips, you can be one less American with chronic dehydration. Splurge on a reusable water bottle. When something's right in front of you, it's hard to ignore. Having a fun water bottle by your side can make it even more exciting to drink water morning, evening, and night. Remember, it's better to drink slowly than gulp it all down at once. Forget plain water. Not sure how you'll come close to drinking your fill of fluids throughout the day. Try adding natural ingredients to your water, like fresh strawberries, cucumbers, or orange or lemon slices. There are also plenty of flavored seltzer waters out there for you to choose from. Eat more water-filled foods. While fruits and vegetables are good for you because of all their nutrients, including vitamins, minerals, and fibers, they also contain large amounts of water. In fact, cantaloupe, watermelon, leafy greens, and tomatoes all contain 90% water. Switch up your snacks. Instead of reaching for pretzels, crackers, or cookies, choose fresh or frozen fruits with yogurt or cut up veggies with hummus when your blood sugar runs low. Paired with protein, these fruits and vegetables can give you the added boost to get through your afternoon. Make small lifestyle changes. If you exercise a lot, you might need more than water. Take a sports drink or coconut water for post-workout. Plus, avoid alcohol consumption if you're already feeling dehydrated, as this increases your fluid loss. Thank you for watching. Your Healthline Matters. Be sure to subscribe to Healthline Matters so you do not miss any of our weekly video tips and secrets to improve your health, fitness, and lifestyle.